I'm sure you're aware of your body and the things your body can do, but how does the structure of your body, the actual composition of it, affect what you can accomplish? The structure of our bodies and their function are very tightly linked. For example, the structure of the eyeball contains specialized receptors and cells. The function of the eye is to turn light into energy that the brain can understand. This basically describes the difference between anatomy and physiology. It's the difference between structure and function. Anatomy is a science that investigates the structure of the human body and provides information about where structures and organs are located and what they're made of, like the parts of the heart. In anatomy labs, you'd likely find students dissecting parts of the human body. Many people donate their bodies post-mortem to science, and this greatly helps our understanding of how the human body functions. The science of anatomy has been around since ancient times, beginning with the dissection of animals in the 3rd century BC in Greece. We've come a long way in understanding human structures since then, but there's still so much to learn. Anatomy provides information about the chemical makeup of structures, types of cells, and how they fit together to make up organs and eventually the entire organism. Gross anatomy is the study of large body structures that can be seen with the human eye, such as whole organs like the heart, lungs, or brain. Like the name suggests, microscopic anatomy is the study of structures that are so small they must be observed through a microscope. If you break down the structures observed in gross anatomy, you arrive in the world of microscopic anatomy. This is the world of cell types like cardiomyocytes in the heart, epithelial cells in the lungs, or neurons in the brain. The way scientists study anatomy is considered either regional or systemic. Regional anatomy is the study of how multiple structures work together to keep one region of the body working properly. For example, the brain is supplied with blood from capillaries, cerebral spinal fluid, or CSF, from the spine, and glucose from food ingested by the stomach. It's also protected by the dura mater of the skull, which insulates the brain and allows CSF to flow through the arachnoid layer. Systemic anatomy is how the structures within one region work together to perform their specific function. In the example of the brain, this would include studying how each part of the brain works to control the body through nerve connections. For example, the primary motor cortex is responsible for sending signals to any part of the body to move it. Of course, it's critical to know where structures are located within our body and what they're made of, but it's also fundamental to understand the unique function of each of these structures. Human physiology is the study of how exactly each structure works to produce a certain outcome to facilitate life. The study of the function of the brain is called neurophysiology. If you took a class on this subject, you'd learn about how specific brain regions have specific functions, what happens if brain regions are damaged, and how brain cells are able to generate electrical impulses to connect to one another and the rest of the body. For instance, the hippocampus is the part of your brain responsible for memory, and is made up of neurons that release chemicals called neurotransmitters after being electrically activated. Release of the neurotransmitter glutamate in the hippocampus would function to increase the ability to take new experiences and create long-term memories. Structure and function are very closely related. In our brain example, the prefrontal cortex is responsible for behaviors that are key to being human, such as the ability to make decisions, think critically, and control impulses. It would make sense that this cortical area should have more neurons than other brain regions that aren't as important, such as the part of your brain that only controls vomiting. And in fact, the reason why the human brain looks so convoluted with dips and grooves is to pack as many neurons as possible into the most important parts of the brain, including the prefrontal cortex. We have more of these grooves than most other animals. So what are some physiology methods that could be used to study brain function? Well, scientists could observe what happens when one part of the brain is stimulated. For example, if a certain part of the motor cortex is activated, a person might automatically move their leg. Another way is to study brain tissue using a variety of laboratory techniques to see how DNA, proteins, and chemicals work to keep each brain region working properly. I hope this overview helped explain the differences between anatomy and physiology and different ways that each can be measured. But the truth is, despite their differences, without one, we wouldn't have the other.